million-dollar casino will open its doors in Sonoma County. So what are other casinos doing to keep local gamblers from fleeing to the Bay Area? KCRA3's Richard Sharp at Thunder Valley Casino tonight with how casino operators plan on doing just that. Richard.
Yeah, and there's a lot of concern over this because the competition for those customers is just so fierce. Well, Thunder Valley behind us here says they have something the new casino doesn't.
I've got 3,000 slot machines, 144 table games, 18 live poker tables. I expect them to fill up.
Fill up with players that might have gone to other casinos like Cache Creek or even Thunder Valley. The competition in this industry is tougher than the odds at the table. Cache Creek Casino draws a high number of players from the Bay Area. They are already targeting loyal customers with a new advertising campaign and better payouts at some games.
For example, in blackjack, most places when you go and get a blackjack, you're paid 6 to 5. Well, now we pay 3 to 2.
And Thunder Valley Casino sees Bay Area traffic, but relies more heavily on a local crowd. Casino spokesman Doug Elmitz doesn't believe the draw for Grayton will have much of an impact here.
We have a hotel, Grayton doesn't. We've got a buffet, Grayton doesn't. We have entertainment, Grayton doesn't.
If Bay Area players do decide to bet local instead of driving to Cache Creek or Thunder Valley, it doesn't only affect those at the table. That's tax money that won't trickle down to local cities and businesses.
I mean, they bring in revenue, I guess, for it's an entertainment revenue, yeah. But I don't really think it's going to matter.
And we also spoke with a fair amount of people today who say regardless of where the new casino is, they don't believe Northern California should have another casino. Live in Lincoln, I'm Richard Sharp, KCRA 3 News.